Penguin Random House Canada presents Reasons to Look at the Night Sky by Danielle Daniel. Read for you by Tara Sky and Jani Lauzon. For Kelly Sonic, with love. We are made of star stuff. Carl Sagan. Waxing Crescent. Eclipse. My parents say I am part sonnet, part stars, born 7 days early on a clear and crisp night during a winter's lunar eclipse. Mom says light snow had fallen all day, blanketing the long canal. She remembers shuffling across it, making tracks as she wrote a new haiku, counting syllables in her head, 5 + 7 + 5. Dad recalls the constellations shining bright, tells me even the Canis Minor could be seen twinkling its starlight. He says I was a born explorer, with my head tilted to the sky, waiting for night to fall and for the stars to dot the black night. Mom wanted to name me after a flower. A flower! Lily, one of her favorites, though by arriving during the lunar eclipse, I commanded a different name, and one I much prefer. Luna. I can't imagine being named after a flower, especially one that looks like a funny trumpet. Space is much more interesting, and my dad would agree. He's an astronomer, and Mom's a florist, even though she says she's a poet first. I wonder if all poets love flowers as much as her. I like quantifiable questions and answers, numbers more than words, measurements and distances, light speed. I like Luna much more than Lily, at least 538 times more. Sky giants. Stars come in different sizes and colors, like flowers, I suppose, or like shoes. They're most easily compared to the size of our sun because our sun is a star too. In fact, it's the closest star to planet Earth. Then we have the white dwarf, 85 times smaller than the sun, the red dwarf, 20 times smaller than the sun, the orange giant, 25 times larger than the sun, the red giant, 50 times larger than the sun, the blue supergiant, 85 times larger than the sun, the blue hypergiant, 330 times larger than the sun, the red hypergiant, 2,000 to 3,000 times larger than the sun. Stars are my jam. Way more than shoes. Leo the Lion. My brother was born under a spring sky. This particular sky doesn't have very bright stars, but the constellation that stands out the most is called Leo, named after a lion in Greek mythology that Hercules fought and killed. However, my brother doesn't really like that part. If you connect the dots, stars, you trace the outline of a lion. Lions are pretty spectacular, majestic and strong. My brother is big and strong too. He's 3 years older than me, in grade 9. Even though we are close, we were very different, and each of us has constellations of our own. Leo doesn't like space like I do. He prefers basketball and video games, his guitar. He always makes time for family game night, though, and he doesn't mind listening to me when I can't stop, won't stop, talking about new space discoveries. Leo has dyslexia. And he likes to invent songs, which comes easier to him because he makes them up in his head with a melody and not on paper where the letters get all jumbled up whenever he has to write them down. In a way, he's more like Mom, and I am more like Dad, which makes our family a balanced equation. I'm really glad Leo's part of my galaxy. Corvus and Cheerios. I'm up first, even before Dad, who is the early riser, and I grab the Cheerios, flick on the radio, minus 15 and snowing. Typical January weather. I splash milk in my bowl.
Hey, Squirt. Up early this morning?
Dad rolls in and presses the neon blue button on the coffee maker, pushes his glasses in place on the bridge of his nose, and wheels across the kitchen in his wheelchair.
Looking forward to going back to school?
88 constellations happy, I say, and feel my heart skipping one and two beats. The space unit starts today.
That's right,
he says, and even his eyebrows smile.
It's become pretty legendary over the years.
Even Leo enjoyed it. Yeah, I feel like I've waited my whole life for this. 10 full pages of a research project space topic of my choice. That will be the most pages for one single project I have ever done, at least so far. Official title page, with a table of contents, bibliography, and charts and diagrams if needed. I already have the protective clear sleeve for the final copy. Mr. Griffin said we would start it right after the holiday break. I'm just glad the electricity unit is over with. That one was torture. Good morning, Mom says, grabbing a cup of coffee in the biggest mug we have, baby blue with chrysanthemums. Today's the day, isn't it, honey? Sure is, Mom. She grins behind her monster mug. Her curly hair looks like a dark halo. And Leo? Still sleeping, I answer. When I glimpse down at my bowl, I spot Corvus the Crow, a small constellation of soggy Cheerios floating in my milk. I gulp the sweet milk and gobble the star bird and consider the pattern of stars now spinning inside me as I eagerly rush to catch my bus. At the bus stop, I reach into my pocket and find a piece of paper folded into a tiny square. A haiku for you. Stars shine above you, twinkling and calling your name. Reach up and touch them. I hope you like it. Love, Mom. XO. I kind of feel bad thinking this, but sometimes I wish Mom would save her poetry for her poetry group, because I speak science and math. But at least this one is about stars. The wheels on the bus. I always sit closer to the front because I get car sick, bus sick, motion sick. This is something I need to fix if I want to become a real astronaut, which I do, more than anything. Mind over matter, as in trying to control my thoughts and not the other kind of matter, solid, liquid, gas, anything that has a mass and takes up space. Like a bus. Or a tree, or Miss Foxglove, who is carefully steering this large bus over the icy roads. There are 4 stops between my stop and Maggie's stop. Elm and pine, spruce and oak, peach and plum, and finally fern and fig. Maggie's family lives on Fig, 899 Fig Street. She waves when she sees me from the curb, and I wave back. No one ever sits beside me between Elm and Fig because they know Maggie and I always sit together, no matter what. Binary star. Maggie Ann Cho and I, Luna Harriet McKenna, have been orbiting around each other since first grade. Maggie loves biology best, but I don't hold that against her. She's obsessed with dolphins and whales and starfish. An environmentalist. No plastic. Never. Reduce, reuse, recycle, conserve. Earth Day is every day. She's a secret keeper, diary writer. Together we love sleepovers, beaver tails, skating parties on the canal. She's devoted to the sea. I'm dedicated to the sky. And together we walk the land at Equinox Public School. I'm glad I have a friend who reminds me to look down sometimes. Pearl. Maggie comes from Margaret, which comes from the Greek margaritaris, lithos, which means pearl. Pearls are found in the sea, inside an oyster, mussel, or clam. They can be white, black, or pink, and vary in size, a lot like stars, or flowers, or shoes. Like a comet. I take my seat in class, with Maggie two spaces behind me, and notice the solar system is not yet on the bulletin board. Neither is the oversized planet poster Mr. Griffin loves so much. The electricity unit has been taken down, but nothing has been put in its place. It's a blank space in between here.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.